That's you again, that's right. He's caught me 20 times. Building there, very sharp young lady. So anyway, it's nice to be here, and I thought what we'd do is give you guys a chance to ask some questions, which I'll be happy to answer, and have some fun. So what you do is, since we're in a small venue here, just if you have a question you'd like to ask about the series, about our show, anything, you can just raise your hand, and I'll answer each question. All right, here's a gentleman over here in the blue shirt.
How'd you land the role of Robin?
How did I get the role of Robin? Well, I was a young actor going to UCLA, studying acting, working with a professional coach, and I was selling real estate on the weekends, and I sold a house along with my father to a producer who was kind enough to watch a scene that I did and then said, you know, I'll tell you what, I'm going to send you to an agent, and the agent can perhaps try to get you some work. So he sent me to this Hollywood agent. The first thing the Hollywood agent said was, I can't get work for the actors I've already got, and I would never take you, but because of this producer, I'm going to do it, so don't expect to work for a year, and if you do get a chance, you'll have one line or something. Very encouraging, right? So I was a couple of weeks later, and then I got a call from someone in that agent's office who said, there's something going on in 20th Century Fox. We don't even know what it is. Just go over there at 4:30 in the afternoon tomorrow, and you'll see a casting director, and you can try out for the part if they want to see you. So I went over there the next day to 20th Century Fox. I didn't have any knowledge what the role was or anything. I just was given a specific bungalow to go to and to meet a certain casting director, which I did. And the casting director was very nice. He said, would you like to meet the executive producer? I figured, sure. I mean, figured everybody got to meet the executive producer. That's actually not true, but I didn't know that at the time. So I went in to see the executive producer. His name was William Dozier. And I said, hello, Mr. Dozier. And I shook his hand really firm, and I think I caught him off guard. He wasn't expecting that kind of energy. And he said, looked at me, said, well, you're kind of big for this part. I said, oh, sir, I promise you, I won't grow anymore. And he laughed. I mean, how can you stop growing? But, and we talked for a little bit, and then he said, would you like to have a screen test? I said, sure. I figured, everybody got to have a screen test, and that's not true either. So a couple of weeks later, I had a screen test at 20th Century Fox, which you can view online if you'd like. It shows me they wanted to see some physical stuff, and I was one of the very first people to learn karate in the United States. We came in 1959, and so I did some stuff, broke a board with my hand, and then they had me, they said, okay, now we need you to do some dialogue with one of the other actors who's trying out for the part. So I was introduced to Adam West, and before we did our screen test together, we were each handed a couple of pages of text, and all it said on it was Bruce and Dick. Didn't say anything about Batman, didn't say anything like that, just simply Bruce and Dick. So I had no idea what the project was, but after talking to Adam West for about 5 minutes, the two of us were laughing, and I think for the last 52 years, we've never stopped laughing. We just got along really, really great. A wonderful, incredible man. So we did the screen test, and I said, thank you very much. And they said, wait, don't, you're not ready to go yet. We have one more thing for you to do. I said, what was that? They said, well, why don't you go over this trailer here? And we've got two wardrobe in there, and they have some clothes they want to help you put on, and so that we can do the second part of the screen test. And I stopped for a second. I guess I was surprised. I said, well, I'm perfectly capable of dressing myself. They said, oh, no, you don't understand. You don't understand. So you just go over there, and I went over there, and sure enough, there was these two wardrobe guys, and I went into this trailer, and this giant long couch, and on the couch was just so much stuff. I figured it must be for three or four different people or something. And I asked them, I said, am I going to put some of this on? They said, no, you're going to put all of it on. I said, what? So I put this costume on. It was the most uncomfortable thing in my entire life I've ever put on. I've never been in such agony. And I could hardly walk. And I turned around to these guys as I was stepping out the door. I said, well, I'm going to do this screen test for about 5 or 10 minutes, then I'm coming back and I'll never have to wear this costume again. Famous last words. So I did the screen test, and I looked at this costume. I still didn't know anything to do with superheroes. I had no idea. You see, where I grew up, they had Superman comic books, but they didn't have Batman and Robin. So, and then when I saw Adam West in this costume, I mean, I couldn't figure out, what is this? What is this? And I'll never forget the first time he turned around and I saw his eyes. See, his eyes in the cowl were crossed. And it just made me laugh instantly. They said, wait, we gotta do the scene, no laughing, please. We gotta, it's very serious, you know. And so anyway, long story short, I did the screen test, still didn't know what it was, left, and for the next 6 weeks, I started getting phone calls from the studio. What's your shoe size? Oh, well, okay. Now, what's your hat size? Well, I don't wear a hat. Well, go get your head measured for all of this stuff. I wonder, why are they calling me asking for this? And then 6 weeks later, I got a call from these agents, and they said, well, we'd like you to come in and sign contracts. I said, oh, well, great. So I figured, gee, they really were going to take me on and represent me. So I went in to sign the contracts, but when I sat down and looked at it, it said 20th Century Fox on the contract. It didn't say the name of the agency. And I asked them, well, what's this? They said, it's your contract with the studio. You don't know that you have the part? I said, no. They said, you mean the studio didn't tell you? No. And it turns out the studio said, you mean the agents didn't tell you that? So I had this part for about 4 of the 6 weeks, and I didn't even realize that. So that, in a lot of words, is how I got the role. Okay? Yes, ma'am.
What was your chemistry like with Adam West?
Amazing. Adam and I had a certain chemistry that, and I wish, believe me, I wish he were here now, that you put the two of us together, and we didn't have to say a word. You would immediately start laughing. And I don't know if it was because his nature was that of this very grand, bigger than life, you know. I mean, people ask me, well, I see him in the show, but what was he like off the show? And I'll tell you, he was exactly the same. He thought of himself like Winston Churchill. I mean, he thought of himself in these gigantic, grand terms. And in fact, one time he said to me, he really, really understood what it was like to play Batman when he watched Charlton Heston play Moses and part the Red Sea. dead serious about that. So, and I was always a kid, never grew up, still haven't, a lot older than a kid, but nevertheless, it's the same. And we just have had an amazing relationship. And I really tell you, I believe one of the reasons our show was so successful is that the two of us had a great time. We played everything straight so that the kids saw it as the hero worship, the adults saw the nostalgia of the comic books, but the teenagers and the college kids that at that time in history did not watch television, now, for the first time, maybe, we're watching our show because of the campy style, the double meanings, the insinuations, the suggestive things that we said and did. And as a result of that, we had a gigantic audience. It was the number one show in the world. The night that it came out, which was Tuesday, January 12th, 1966, Batman had a 55 share. And what that meant was, in the entire of North America, of all the televisions on in North America, 55% were watching Batman. And the other 45% were sharing other stations, local and network. And so it was really gigantic. To give you an idea, it was bigger than the Super Bowl at the time. That's the kind of thing. And it became a smash hit. You know, the people that were doing the Bat-Tuesday and the women that were having their hairstyle in a Batman hairstyle, and kids were putting capes on or bath towels around their neck, and, you know, jumping off their couch, and, you know, just everything you can imagine. You know, it was really spectacular. Yes, sir.
What was it like to work with Burgess and Frank and Julie and Victor?
Well, they were all great. And people ask me all the time, oh, you had so many great stars, but which was your favorite? And there wasn't a favorite, because every one of these people was somebody that I grew up watching either on television or in film, you know what I mean? And so every one of these was a star to me, and I was like the kid in the candy store that I was thrilled to have the opportunity to work with. And there were some really famous, very, very, even way before I was born, actors and actresses. Like, for example, Tallulah Bankhead played Black Widow. And in that same show, one of the old bad guys, George Raft, was in that show. And for any of you that are older, you might remember. But we had wonderful actors in that. You had Burgess Meredith, the consummate professional, Cesar Romero, never missed a line. I mean, he was just unbelievable. Frank Worsham became a very dear friend of mine. Very funny, just naturally funny, with a completely rubber face. I mean, the face was just, he could do anything with his face. And one of my favorites also was Vincent Price, and who played Egghead. But I must tell you, when he first came on the set, because I'd seen some of his movies, and I was, to be honest with you, a little afraid, you know, when I first saw it, like, whoa. But he turned out to be a great guy. There was a funny scene, if you'd like to know some of the stuff that you can't read about. I had a scene near the end of that show where he had me, he like grabbed me around the neck, and with his arm, and he was taking eggs and breaking them on my head. And Batman came into the scene. The two of them were to have dialogue together. And then Egghead was to let go of me, and I was to pick up an egg and throw it at him, and, you know, hit him in the face with the egg. Well, Adam and him kind of got together and said, let's mess up a few lines. Let's have some fun. You have to understand, they were breaking three eggs on my head, Egghead was, every time the scene did. So when you do it like six or seven times, it's like almost 21 eggs. And I was getting dizzy from that. I mean, I know it's, you wouldn't think so, but you get hit with 21 eggs and they're still hard. And I had egg shampoo, I called it, going down my back into my undershorts. It was not fun. It was not fun. So finally, when they got it right, they thought they'd kind of teased me enough, they got it right, that instead of just picking up an egg and throwing it at Egghead, I picked up a whole dozen eggs. And instead of throwing them, I went over and I hit him so hard on his egg, the top of his head, that it actually moved the egg. So if you watch closely, you see his egg was a little off tilt, because it wasn't seen. I was furious. Yes, sir?
She's had her hand up for longer, so I'll let her go first.
You like to have a question? All right. Are you Robin? That's what you said to me earlier. All right, there we go.
How young were you when you started acting?
Well, I started acting. Well, what is starting? Mean starting professionally or starting training or, you know? I mean, actually, I started in show business much younger than most people. My father owned a traveling ice show, and my father, which was the predecessor to Ice Capades. And at age two, he put me in the show, and I skated by myself around an arena, which is, you know, pretty something here for a two-year-old, right? So I started working at age two, and then started acting when I got the part of Robin. And let's see, I'm 29 now, so I must be 29. I was 20 years old, going on 21, had to have my contract approved by court because I wasn't old enough legally to sign an agreement. So that's the answer. Yes, sir.
Return of the Caped Crusader is the most brilliant animated movie I've ever seen in my life. Okay.
Thank you.
It gives everything else. It's like Adult Swim had a baby with Batman and created that. I mean, it was fantastic.
Well, listen, I've got a surprise for you, although you probably know, a week from Tuesday, our second feature from Warner Brothers comes out. It's called Batman versus Two-Face. And I can tell you, it's even better. It is amazing. Adam West did the voice of Batman before he passed on. Did a great job. I did the voice of Robin. And Two-Face, this villain from the comic books that was not in our series, but from the comic books, is portrayed by none other than William Shatner. So here you have two most iconic TV shows in history, Batman and Star Trek, the actual. actors were lived together. And I'll tell you something, he is phenomenal. He is amazing. He, Two-Face is also two characters in one, and he plays both fabulous. Yes, sir?
Who is your favorite villain?
Well, like I said earlier, I've worked with so many actors.
There are no favorites.
Not necessarily one, but there were a lot of favorites, if you know what I mean. A lot of people that I had a thrill working with. Yes, yes, sir.
Oh, yes. I was wondering, you said a lot of the holy references in the show. Which ones are some of your favorite holy things?
Well, you have to understand, the script writers wrote those. However, because we had 32 different writers, not all of them got the style of Batman the way that Adam and I envisioned it and the way the producers envisioned it. So they gave me the flexibility to make changes. In the series, the 120 episodes, I said 378 holies. 378. When you add in the Batman movie, it went to over 400. So, you know, it wasn't that there was a favorite. It had to be tied to something we were doing. In other words, it had to make sense. And sometimes they would write something that didn't have anything to do with what we were doing, so I got to change it. And by the way, for those of you who might be interested, because Batman was a really sophisticated show in terms of production value, with all the explosions and the effects and the contraptions and stuff like that, the producers and the director and the crew mainly focused on all these effects to make them work. So Adam and I, other than being basically said, well, you know, we'd like to do this when you're at the car, or we'd like to do this at the bat computer, we were basically left to do things the way we wanted. So when you watch the show and you see me jump over the door into the car, or jump over the door out of the Batmobile, that was something I just did on my own. When I walked along the edge in a couple of the shows where I walked along the edge of the Batmobile, I didn't realize that George Barris, who made the Batmobile, was having fits, you know, watching me and saying, oh my God, it's gonna ruin the paint job and all this kind of stuff, you know. But I, you know, it was part of the thing, and things like hitting my fist into my palm and all of the stuff that you saw were stuff that I was able to do by myself. And in fact, just so you know, given the perspective, there were 1,100 young actors interviewed for this role. 1,100. And when I was selected, executive producer William Dozier came to me and said, would you like to know why we selected you to play the part of Robin? I said, yes, sir. And he said, the reason we selected you was because if there really was a Robin, forget television, there really was a Robin, we personally think that you would be it. So we don't want you to quote act. We really just want you to be yourself and be enthusiastic, which is what I did.
I have to interject. I'm getting a sign that it is almost time for your flight. But before you go, this was something we did the other day that I just loved. If everybody closes their eyes, could you give us a holy Hamilton Batman? And I swear, it's
that's
like,
not one in the script.
It's 1966 all over again when he does this. It's crazy. Everybody close your eyes. Go ahead.
Holy Hamilton Batman! Yes, next Sunday, a week from today, William Shatner and I will be at the New York Comic Con, where they will premiere the movie. It's going to come, you know, be shown to the people at the Comic Con. There's over 100,000 people that are going to be there. And then we're going to do a panel, do a lot of press. Then Tuesday, which is the 10th, it'll be digital download. And a week from that day, October 17th, Batman will be released Blu-ray and DVD. And by the way, I was given a really pleasant surprise by Warner Brothers on that DVD that's going to be available, and if you pick up a copy, you'll get this as well. There's a featurette, and the featurette is 14 minutes long, and it's called The Wonderful World of Burt Ward, which, I mean, to be honest with you, you know, to me, growing up, that was Disney's, and I didn't think I earned that one, but in any event, they talk about the fact that the friendship that Adam and I had, the fact that from being, I like to say, from the Cape Crusader to the Canine Crusader of you know, we were rescuing lives of Batman, and now I'm saving animals' lives, all of which is pure charity. And in fact, also, not yet in Canada, but coming, my wife and I, taking nothing from it, have created a dog coon called Gentle Giants that our dogs are living up to 27 years. Healthy and active. No one in the world has been able to do this. It's going to be coming to Canada. We take nothing from it. In fact, it sells for half the price of what you pay for dog food in a pet store. And we like to say half the price, twice the life. That's our charity. We've got more projects to do with Warner Brothers and another big TV series that I'm working on right now. Okay?
Awesome.